a stronger alliance. That's the pitch of U.S. President Joe Biden to visiting Philippine counterpart Ferdinand Marcos Jr. during their meeting at the White House. Both leaders agreed there is a need to elevate Manila and Washington's partnership amid geopolitical concerns. Pia Gutierrez reports from Washington.
U.S. President Joe Biden once again affirmed Washington's ironclad commitment to the defense of the Philippines and the South China Sea. He made that assurance during his bilateral meeting with Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. at the White House Monday afternoon, where both leaders committed to further strengthen the alliance of the United States and the Philippines. During their meeting, Biden told Marcos Jr. that amid geopolitical challenges, he could not think of a better partner than the Philippines, with whom the United States shares a deep friendship. He also assured of their continued support for the modernization of the Philippine military.
When we met in New York last year, you told me that that a strong alliance has to continue, quote, and this is your phrase, to evolve as we face the challenges of this new century. And we are facing new challenges. And I can't think of any better partner to have than you. I couldn't agree more that we have to, this relationship has to continue to evolve. And the United States also remains ironclad in our commitment to the defense of the Philippines, including the South China Sea. And we're going to continue to support the Philippines' military modernization goals. Mr. President, our countries not only share a strong partnership, we share a deep friendship, one that has been enriched by millions of Filipino Americans and the communities all across the United States of America.
This comes amid shared concerns over China's continued aggression in the West Philippine Sea, the most recent of which is the harassment of a maritime patrol vessel of the Philippines by the Chinese Coast Guard, which caused a near collision at the Iungan Shoal. In the same meeting, Biden also announced that he will send a first-of-its-kind presidential trade and investment mission to the Philippines. Meanwhile, President Marcos Jr., for his part, raised the need for countries to find ways to strengthen alliances and partnerships in the post-pandemic economy. But beyond that, he says there are also issues that places the Philippines in arguably the most complicated geopolitical situation in the world right now. Marcos Jr. says it is but natural for the Philippines to look to its sole treaty partner in the world, the United States, and to further strengthen and redefine its relationship with the U.S., as well as the roles that the countries play in the face of these tensions.
There are also the issues, geopolitical issues, that have made the region where the Philippines is arguably the most complicated geopolitical situation in the world right now. And so it is only natural that for the Philippines to look to its sole treaty partner in the world to strengthen and to redefine the relationship that we have and the roles that we play in the face of those rising tensions that we see now around the South China Sea and Asia Pacific and Indo-Pacific regions.
This is Biden and Marcos Jr.'s second meeting following their bilateral talks September last year at the sidelines of the United Nations General Assembly in New York. Following his meeting in the White House, President Marcos Jr. met with members of the Filipino community at the Ritz-Carlton in Washington, where he thanked the Filipinos in America for working to make a good name to the Philippines with their hard work and sacrifice. He said that his dream for them ultimately is for them to come home to a better Philippines. According to the DFA, there are about 4.4 million Filipinos currently living in the United States. And that's the latest here in Washington, D.C. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippines and the U.S. also looking forward to establishing trilateral modes of cooperation with Japan as well as Australia. Meanwhile, an official from Japan's ruling Liberal Democratic Party also affirmed his country's support for the Philippines over the West Philippine Sea issue. For security analyst Chester Cabalza, Marcos's meeting with America's leader is also about sending a message to China. He also notes Manila's important role in keeping regional peace.
The message that we are seeing right now is that Manila is committed to its treaty alliance with Washington, and at the same time, we wanted to tell to China that we subscribe to maritime rules-based norms and to institutional norms. And also at the same time, we have to consider that since Washington is a treaty ally, it could also be an economic partner in the region. So these are very crucial for the Philippines, for the in a way that we are doing a balancing, delicate balancing act as of the moment. So it sends also a signal to China that we could nurture our role as a middle power for these two superpowers, in which case we can deal with them in a very delicate way.
The meeting between Presidents Biden and Marcos didn't make the headlines of top news outlets in America, as it was overshadowed by the looming U.S. debt default. Our North America Bureau Chief TJ Manotok now joins us with that story. TJ, good afternoon from Manila.
Hi, good afternoon, Kamina. Well, yeah, as much as there was so much pride for Filipinos here in the U.S. to support President Marcos, when a historic visit at the White House for him and for the Philippines, it really did not create much buzz, if any, amongst the local media. And likely it's because the biggest story coming out of the White House today was the concern that the U.S. could run out of cash by June 1. That was the stern warning from Janet Yellen, the Treasury Secretary. She is appealing to the Congress to raise or suspend the debt limit so that the U.S. could continue paying its bills. President Biden, the biggest statement that came out from him at the White House today was that he announced that he would be meeting with lawmakers on May 9, Republican leaders specifically, to discuss ways to avoid the default. So that was really the biggest headline grabber from the White House today. And you may see it as unfortunate, because usually when a foreign leader comes to the White House for a state visit, for a bilateral meeting in the White House at the Oval Office, that is given significant attention, but it just was not the case today for President Marcos. So possibly some bad timing, or you know, it's hard to second guess the decision of producers and editors of network news and of newspapers. But if you scan CNN, New York Times, ABC News, NBC News, it's hard to find an article about the visit of President Marcos. But nonetheless, that's just for media perspective. But the job to be done is by the two presidents and the respective teams to put their heads together and make the necessary work together in terms of what they announced today and what they want to do moving forward. But interestingly as well, Carmina, outside the White House, though, you know, there were dozens of Filipino activists who greeted, quote-unquote, greeted President Marcos for the protest at the Lafayette Park. Just outside the White House, it's as iconic and historic it may seem, or it shows to show President Marcos meeting President Biden inside the White House. It's also a very visual thing to see, you know, Filipino-American protesters outside the White House with the White House as their backdrop. You know, they had an all-day vigil, and their protest was meant to, as they said, send a loud message to President Marcos that he, as they would say, he's not welcome in the United States. The bilateral meeting, of course, of Marcos and Biden came just days after the conclusion of the largest joint U.S.-Philippine military exercises, totaling 17,000 troops, which the protesters are saying they feel it's a direct provocation to China. They fear that the U.S.-Philippine military alliance in the West Philippine Sea could end up getting the Philippines involved in a U.S.-China tension that could blow up into a full-scale war between the superpowers. But not all of them feel this way. Other committee members have different views, such as Eric Lachica, the U.S. Filipinos for Good Governance, who is aligned with prominent philams like Lloyd de Luis Nicolas and Rodel Rodes. Now, they believe that President Biden could use the bilateral meeting to pressure Marcos Jr. in doing the right thing when it comes to human rights in the Philippines. One, they say as well, is to leverage the release of Senator De Lima during the bilateral talks. And Lachica added that he believes that Marcos Jr.'s action in the West Philippine Sea is a step in the right direction. But Biden needs to make sure that all these military aid to the Philippines should be with a condition that no U.S. taxpayer money should be given to the Philippines if the human rights situation in the Philippines is not addressed. He also added that he hopes President Marcos could push for legislation that would recognize Amerasians in the Philippines and eventually bring these American kids home to the U.S. So interesting to see, Carmina, how there are varying opinions, varying beliefs of how some Philippine Americans view this visit of President Marcos. But nonetheless, it is historic, and we have a few more days to see how he, you know, addresses the community in Washington, D.C. And as he said, he'll be speaking with other, you know, interested stakeholders here in the U.S., how they can further enhance the relationship with the Philippines and as well invest in the Philippines. So that's the latest we have from here. Camina, back to you.
Ajit, just one question for you, Teach, before we let you go. Of course, the two leaders at the core of the discussion at the White House, the geopolitical concerns, particularly China at its core, right? So the question is that even a discussion between and among American families? Is that a great concern of the American public, what China has been doing in this part of the world, and how the U.S. has been reacting to that?
Well, it is in the news cycle, Carmina, with regards to more than anything Taiwan, and as well, you know, the region in particular, but very little mention of the Philippines, to be specific. But there is concern. It is in the awareness that there are those tensions in the West Philippine Sea, and that you don't see any political surveys that would show that they are averse to that. Mm-hmm. That the U.S. supports the Philippines and other countries who are feeding the aggression of China. So, you know, just to gander a guess on that, it's not an issue for them that the U.S. is showing that support to an ally in the Philippines and Taiwan. So it's interesting to see how that progresses. I don't think it's something that's going to be a hot issue in the presidential debates that are coming up with the primaries that will be coming up later in the year and next year. But nonetheless, it is something that has been discussed in the news cycle from time to time, and it's not something that is totally, you know, totally alien to them at all.
Mm-hmm. Okay, maybe it's going to blow up, maybe not, but it's all a matter of time. Mm-hmm. Our North America Bureau Chief there, TJ Manotok, joining us on the line. Thanks, Teej.